May 23rd. My first batch of subjects arrived today. And I have to admit that I'm very excited. This could be the dawn of a new age. Nuclear power is meaningless in a world where a virus can kill an entire population and leave its wealth intact. May 27th. Commander Prothero toured the lab with a priest, Father Lilleman, who I was told is here to monitor for rules and rights violations. It made me nervous, but afterwards the commander assured me there wouldn't be a problem. June 2nd. I keep wondering if these people knew how they might be helping their country, if they would act any differently. They're so weak and pathetic. They never look you in the eye. I find myself hating them. August the 18th. Of the original 4 dozen, over 75% are now deceased. No controllable pattern has yet emerged. September the 18th. There is one case that continues to give me hope. He exhibits none of the immune system pathologies of the other subjects developed. I've discovered several cellular anomalies in his blood that I've been unable to categorize. The mutations seem to have triggered the abnormal development of basic kinesthesia and reflexes. The subject said he could no longer remember who he was or where he was from. Whoever he was, he is now the key to our dream. And the hope that all of this will not have been in vain. November the 5th. It started last night, around midnight. The first explosions tore open the entire medical section. All my work, gone. I was trying to understand how it could have happened, and I saw him, the man from room 5. He looked at me. Not with eyes. There were no eyes. But I know he was looking at me because I felt it.